Hello, Wellness Warriors. Welcome back to the Entheogen Explorer channel. So I'm currently living here in Indonesia, in Bali, and the food here is absolutely delicious. And a lot of it contains something called monosodium glutamate, or MSG. So I wondered to myself if eating MSG on a regular basis is healthy or not. Now, MSG is a pretty common food additive in a number of different countries, including the United States, where it's added to a number of different processed foods. It's meant to enhance flavor. So when I searched for the answer on the World Wide Web about whether MSG was healthy and safe or just completely inert and neutral, I wasn't really happy with the answers that I found. It seemed to lack a sense of unity and cohesiveness in people's opinions about MSG in the diet. So I decided to dive deeper into figuring out the truth for myself. So I made this video for you guys so that I could share what I discovered in my quest for truth to fully understand monosodium glutamate. So before we get into the little known science on monosodium glutamate, I thought I should tell you a little bit about what it actually is. So MSG is a type of salt that is a combination of a sodium ion and the amino acid glutamate. Now, sometimes glutamic acid and glutamate are used interchangeably, so don't get confused if you hear different terms. But in this video, I'm just gonna stick to the term glutamate. So monosodium glutamate is a food additive that is deemed safe for human consumption by the FDA, and it adds a very full and savory umami flavor to meals and to packaged and processed foods all around the globe. So as you probably know, we have five different types of taste. We have sweet, sour, salty, bitter, and then umami. The umami taste that comes from monosodium glutamate is said to augment the other flavors in the meal and to synergize the different senses and tastes in a meal, creating a more full and savory tasting experience. Many foods contain naturally occurring monosodium glutamate in them, which gives them a umami flavor that adds to their irresistible taste. Some foods like this include tomatoes, mushrooms, cheeses, and yeast fermentation products such as soy sauce. Oh, and did I mention that glutamate is also an excitatory neurotransmitter that is responsible for prompting action potentials and electrical currents in the nervous system? Now, MSG earned a bad rep for its association in American Chinese food. After eating at an American Chinese restaurant, some reported feelings of dizziness, headache, weakness, and heart palpitations. They attributed these symptoms to the presence of MSG in the food. And this coined the term Chinese restaurant syndrome that we hear today. There's much controversy about whether MSG can actually cause these symptoms or not. And placebo-controlled clinical trials have shown that there does not appear to be any increase of likelihood of experiencing these symptoms after consuming MSG. Many believe that the stigma of MSG is actually a result of racism and xenophobic fear, and that the effects of MSG are actually not unhealthy. When I did a basic search of the internet, I found a lot of opinions that all the hype around MSG being bad for you was largely inaccurate, but I'm a scientist and I wanted to dive a little bit deeper and understand this from a scientific perspective. Now, what I discovered when I dove into the scientific literature was that there was actually a plethora of scientific research supporting the theory that MSG was neurotoxic to brain cells due to its excitatory nature. It appears that MSG can push the brain towards this pathology called glutamate excitotoxicity, which basically is when you get excess stimulation of a neuron, which results in increased free radical generation, oxidative damage, and creates stress and damage to the cell or even kills the entire cell. Now, if you want to dive deeper into glutamate excitotoxicity, I have another video that I made just on that so you can understand it a little bit more. But ultimately, this is sort of the way that we see MSG causing problems is through excessive stimulation of the glutamate receptors. Now, much of the debate that I actually came across amongst the science was about the methodology of these certain experimental designs. For example, some of the studies were injecting MSG purely into mice and were like, well, no shit, that's gonna cause problems. You could inject salt into someone and that would probably also cause some issues. And, you know, they argued that that's not really how people are consuming MSG, therefore that's not an appropriate model. And also, people are criticizing the conclusions that you can draw from rat studies about human biology, all of which are very valid concerns. However, I found some rat studies that involve the oral administration of MSG in doses that are comparable to what human beings would be experiencing in their food. And those studies illustrated a very clear indication that significant neurotoxicity was occurring based on the brains of the sacrificed rats that they analyzed. In these studies, they found that MSG was causing oxidative stress and resulting in cell death or apoptosis of neurons. Now, brain cells and immune cells are particularly susceptible to oxidative damage because they're largely composed of fats and lipids that are very vulnerable and sensitive to these free radical oxygen species. The studies also highlighted that there was mild toxicity to the liver and kidneys, where they witnessed chronic and low-grade inflammation as a result of receiving MSG, in addition to genotoxic effects where there was actually damage to genetic material occurring after exposure to MSG through oral means, which were comparable to what humans would ingest in food. In one long-term rat studies where there was chronic administration through the food of MSG in comparable doses to what humans would receive, the MSG-treated group had significant increase in mortality, as well as infertility, low testosterone levels in males, inflammation and fibrosis in the liver and kidneys, as well as increased levels of cholesterol and triglycerides in the blood. Many rat studies show a causal relationship between monosodium glutamate and obesity, and there are some human studies that support this theory, though they're a bit more controversial and some claim that the methods were not scientifically rigorous enough. Now, we know that consumption of MSG can result in increased levels of glutamate in the bloodstream. Some argue that because glutamate doesn't cross the blood-brain barrier, that it doesn't get into the brain or cause any sort of excitotoxicity to brain neurons. However, this doesn't quite make sense because we forget that there's actually a number of neurons and nerve cells in other parts of our body, especially our guts. The neurons in our intestines are just as susceptible to glutamate excitotoxicity and overexcitation as the neurons in our brain. This excitation from our gut neurons can relay excitotoxic signals to our brain by causing chemical cascade reaction that increases neurotoxicity from the glutamate that we're receiving in the MSG. Also, some people have compromised gut-brain permeability, and their blood-brain barrier is actually leaky, therefore they're more susceptible to glutamate sort of slipping past and going into the brain, which may be the reason why some people appear to be sensitive to monosodium glutamate while others are not. Now, many people really like to use the argument that when they did the scientific placebo-controlled studies for headache, dizziness, heart palpitations, and weakness, that they found no correlation with MSG to those symptoms, and therefore MSG has no ill effects whatsoever. The problem with that as an idea is it doesn't take into account the molecular damaging effects of MSG, like excitotoxicity and oxidative stress. All this really proves is that MSG is not causing these acute symptoms that people were claiming. However, it doesn't necessarily equate to that it causes no harm whatsoever. Especially when we look at oxidative stress, we see that it's a cumulative thing that can contribute to the development of other diseases such as cancer, neurodegenerative diseases, depression, metabolic issues and chronic inflammatory diseases. So just because we're not getting a headache after consuming MSG doesn't mean that it's not promoting a pathogenic mechanism in the body that is contributing to your overall health or lack of health. This is one of the reasons why rat models are incredibly helpful, because we do have the privilege and luxury of being able to actually look into their brains after we sacrifice them for science, you know? Yes, it's true, rat studies don't always translate into human beings. However, the glutamate neurotransmitter system, we have learned so much about it through using research with rats. And because monosodium glutamate is largely involving the glutamate signaling, I would assume that the validity of all the other understanding that we have about the glutamate system would be applicable to applying with monosodium glutamate, seeing as how there seems to be quite a bit of consistency amongst mammals, especially amongst rats and humans, as far as how that signaling works. So I think it's a fair assumption to feel confident that a lot of the rat studies with monosodium glutamate shed a lot of light on what's potentially happening in humans' bodies with monosodium glutamate. So while eating the occasional dose of MSG certainly won't kill you, it might be wise to exercise caution in eating it on a consistent and regular basis, as there does appear to be evidence that it is excitotoxic to neurons and contributes to oxidative stress and damage. Oxidative stress is often the primer for a number of different diseases, including cancer, metabolic diseases, autoimmunity, mental illnesses, and neurodegenerative diseases such as Alzheimer's, cognitive decline, and Parkinson's disease, all of which have glutamate excitotoxicity connected to them. So it's possible that regular consumption of monosodium glutamate could put someone at risk for developing these types of conditions, because it will increase the amount of oxidative stress and damage that's happening in your body and create an environment that is well suited for the development of these diseases. So, in summary, don't be afraid to indulge in some MSG-laden Chinese food every once in a while, but maybe consider not eating MSG on a regular basis. So if you can't stand the thought of giving up your precious MSG, but you want to protect your brain from the excitotoxic and oxidative effects from it, then don't fret, I got your back. Check out our nutritional supplement, Transcend. It has 17 different scientifically studied ingredients in it for brain and mood health, and a number of the ingredients have been selected for their ability to protect against glutamate excitotoxicity and oxidative stress. So if you want to eat all of the MSG that you can possibly consume and protect your brain, then check out Transcend. There's a link in the description below. You can get 20% off if you want to give it a shot. If you enjoyed this video, feel free to subscribe so that you don't miss any more earth-shattering announcements and education that I have for you. I love you guys, and I will catch you next time. Mwah! Now, MSG has earned a bad rep. Fly flew in my face. The nerve cells and neurons in your intestines are just as susceptible to glutamate crossing. Fuck this fly.